I'm back in a field that we visited, I think it was the middle of May, and now this is about the 5th of July.
And this
is one of the many common fields in this area of Indiana that received not just one excessive rainfall event, but a number of them throughout the spring. This field was originally planted about April 18th, and it was replanted, or parts of it were replanted, about 1st of June. And I'm standing in one of the many low-lying areas in the field where water literally stood for some number of days. And then, of course, as the water receded, remained saturated for even more days after that. So as we look out across this low-lying area, we still see quite a few of the original plants that survived. They certainly are not uniform, and you've got plants that are reasonably short, and then some of the survivors that were did a little bit better coming out of it. But just a very low population area, and in terms of a replant decision, this is sort of what we'd call a no-brainer, that the original population was so low that certainly you were going to replant through it. What was uncertain at the time was how many of these original ones were going to survive. And I think in hindsight, if I was going to do it over, I probably would have tried to come in and take out these survivors, because it doesn't look like a lot of plants from the original planting, but they are certainly thick enough in places that they are out competing the plants that came up with the replanting. And so we've walked into some of the stands of the original plants, and today they are approximately the 13 leaf collar stage. And the plants in this low-lying area that were from the replanting operation, they're only about 6 leaf collar stage. And what that will translate to approximately in terms of pollination timing is that these late emerging replant areas, they will be pollinating somewhere between 10 and 14 days after the rest of the field has finished pollinating. Nothing terribly dramatic about that per se, other than the fact that means that come harvest time, there's going to be some pretty significant grain moisture differences harvesting through these later developing areas that are going to have wetter grain. One of the consequences that we fear when we replant into surviving stands is that overpopulation. But in a field like this, where that replanting occurred 3 or 4 weeks after the original planting, the difference in growth stage between these two plantings is such that the original planting will outcompete the younger one. The younger ones, in effect, become weeds, but the only consequence is that you wasted a little bit of seed here. I think the yield of these surviving original plants will be affected very little by the presence of these now stunted replanted ones. When the replanting occurs closer to the time of the original, so that there's not as big of a difference in stage between these two plantings, then that becomes a little different story, because then maybe a 60,000 population of a mixture of replant and original that are maybe only 1 or 2 leaves difference in age, that's a different story, and then there can be effects both directions on the replant and the original. But here we're separated by about 7 leaf stages, and that's why the replant in these limited areas of the field are not going to do anything, and eventually they're probably going to wither up and die. All right, so what we're showing here, this field was planted with 2 hybrids, 1/2 the planter with one, 1/2 with the other. And we wanted to stop and show you this demarcation line, as it were, between the 2 hybrids, because it's really striking as you go across the field that one of these hybrids, the one over here that's in this area, has been replanted completely, simply didn't handle those early season conditions, which included one or more of the following: the saturated soil conditions. This is not a low-lying area, this is simply a wetter part of the field. So saturated soil conditions, even though this is strip till, the seed furrow area crusted up pretty good after those heavy rains, so this hybrid had a little more trouble emerging through the crust. And then following that April planting, we had several events of cold weather that were enough to chill the plant or shock the plant. So for whatever those reasons, one hybrid simply did not tolerate one or more of all those early season stresses. And it's pretty clear from the videos and shots we've taken from above with the drone. And this area right here then is an example where that difference in the hybrids is such that one hybrid needed to be replanted. The other hybrid, it's not a perfect stand. It is a little thinner than what you want, but there's a critical number of plants there that told you at the time this probably didn't deserve to be replanted. So, you know, I've talked often about the fact that hybrid choice is a very important decision that you make before planting every season. And it's not just about looking for hybrids with great yield potential, but this certainly should reinforce the fact that other characteristics that are important in choosing hybrids include their tolerance to early season stresses. That can make just a world of difference on whether you get acceptable stand versus stands that need to be replanted.